Welcome to Sick Backers YouTube channel. I'm Steve. Today I'm going to be showing you how to debadge your 2024. It doesn't just go for the 2024, but that's what we're going to be doing it on today. But I'm going to show you how we debadge our tanks and add the bar and shield logos. Now, I get all of mine from JH Choppers, and I'll put a link down in the description down below. But if you notice, on the 2024, the tank is slightly different than the 23 standard and older bike. So this badge is going to be made for the 23 CVO and the 24 and newer style tanks. It's got a little bit different curve to the back side of it, and we've got a set of black ones here that we're going to be putting on. Now I'll go through the steps on how I remove the badge, how I clean up the tank, polish it, clean it, and then stick this, and how I actually place this. Now you can get these tank badges in various different flavors, so if you contact JH Choppers, like I said, I'll put the link down in the description down below to the website and also to the Facebook page, so you can reach out to him if you've got any special requests that you may want to do with that, and he may be able to do that for you. But like I said, we got the gloss black ones today that we're going to be putting on it. Now I've already taken the badges off this tank, but I'm going to show you how we get it off. I was actually over here taking this badge off and thought, man, this would be a pretty good video because I get a lot of questions on this. How do you get this off? How do you clean up all the gunk? And then of course, how to get the new one stuck and make sure that it's on there correctly. So what I use, these little plastic pry tools. I get these on Amazon. You can pick them up just about anywhere though, but I'll put a link to the ones that I got from Amazon. I think they're a different color now. They were yellow when I purchased them, and I think the link now, I think they're red, but they're the same thing. It's just a dash kit plastic. It's stiff, but it's pretty soft. It's got sharp edges on the end, so you can really get behind these tank badges and do that. There's a couple of different ways of doing this. You can try heating it up and trying the fishing string and all that good stuff, but we don't really mess with that. Most of the time you have to get the badge so hot that the fishing string, when you stick it behind there, the fishing string melts and breaks because you're putting so much pressure on it. And so I just use these. I've never had any issues using these on marring the paint. So this is what we use. We just take this and we get behind here and we just work this. Now, like I said, I've got this kind of just temporarily stuck back on here, but you can see all of the residue that it does leave on the tank. And a lot of times it's a lot worse than this. The good thing about these tank badges is Harley Davidson didn't design this very well, and it didn't stick very well either. You can flip it over on the backside and you can see exactly where it was stuck. It was stuck a little bit here on this edge and about a quarter of the badge right here on the backside. So that's where most of your residue is going to be left on your tank. All of this in here is pretty clean because it didn't even stick to the tank. And it was the same way on both sides. So look at that backside on that one. So it was a little bit stuck around the edges, nothing stuck in the middle. So there you go, $32,000+ for a 2024, and the tank badge is barely stuck on the bike. So it makes it super easy for us to get off though, so we do appreciate that. There's a couple of different methods of getting this cleaned up. Of course, you can always use this crap and make a ginormous mess. It works pretty good, but it is time consuming, and like I said, it does make a big mess. Now, I don't just spray this on here and let it drip everywhere. What I do is put a little squirt on there, take my terry cloth, and actually rub it in. There'll be a lot of oil left on the tank, so make sure that it's oily, and then leave it and go on the other side and start working on that side of the bike. And it's a lot of just back and forth. You got to go to that side and work it, come back to this side and work it. So that's the way that you can do that. Goo Gone works really good. It's just time consuming and very messy. Second way to do it is get one of these erasers. I picked these up on Amazon. I think I got two or three different ones, and they all work pretty well the same. Put it on a drill, turn it sideways, run it across there. It's super soft, but it takes all that goo off. It does make a mess with the little yellow stuff that comes off this. So this makes a lot of static electricity when you're running this across the tank. So all that little yellow residue that comes off that eraser kind of sticks to everything. So we'll cover up all this stuff down here, but it's gonna get some back here and some back here. So we just take this and we just blow it off. We're gonna put this on here and we're gonna start in the front and just work our way back. Now, if you got a little hazing like this from the rubber, it's easily polished out, and you can do this by hand. You don't have to use a polisher because it's just a haze that's on there. So you can take just like maybe a normal round wax pad and just keep going over it in a circle until you get that hazing off. I got a little bit right here and maybe a tad right there, but I've got a polisher, so I'm gonna use that. And the product I'm gonna use is called the Last Cut. It's a compound glaze, so it kind of breaks down as you do it. It's going to cut that, and and then as the glaze breaks down, it turns into a polish, so it'll polish it as well. We're just gonna put it on a medium pad and just hit that real quick. Now that took all that little haze off right there. Didn't take a whole lot. Like I said, you can do that by hand if you don't have a polisher. You don't have to worry about that. That doesn't happen very often. Usually with the eraser wheel, that doesn't happen, but it did. So it cleans up very easy though. But if you want to use this, you don't have to worry about doing any of that. It just takes longer to get it off. Before we stick this, we want to make sure we get any of our polishes off, any of the eraser stuff. Definitely if you use this, because this has oil in it, then your tank badges aren't going to stick if there's leftover oil on this. So we use a surface prep. This is called Q2M prep by Geon. You can use all kinds of different ones. You can actually make your own if you want to. It's an alcohol, isopropyl alcohol spray. So it's basically just alcohol and water mixed. This stuff just smells a little better. But we're gonna spray that down. We're gonna take our cloth and clean that real good. And that's gonna remove any oils, waxes, anything like that. Even if you didn't polish your bike, if you have any kind of waxes on your bike, you wanna make sure to remove it before you stick your badges. Now when you're sticking these, it's best if you can get the bike upright. It doesn't have to be on a lift, but maybe on a jack, or maybe have somebody come out and set on the bike and get the bike upright. With it on the Jiffy stand and it's leaning over this way, it's kind of hard to gauge how you're putting it on. So make sure the bike is upright and straight. Now if we take our old tank badge and we look where this center point is, this was about right here. Now I made a mental note of this earlier when I was taking this one off. That's about the center of where that one goes. So before you take this off, you may want to put a piece of painter's tape down here or up here and mark the center. And then that way you have a reference for the center of this one. So we want this one roughly right in that same place in the center of where the other one was. And you can kind of float this around on the tank a little bit to find out where it lays out the best. If you look at your gas cap, this point right here is going to be even with the edge of the gas cap, not the actual fill ring hole, but the edge of the gas cap itself, the backside. If you drew a straight line down, you can put it right there just like that. Good about putting tank badges on is you can never see both sides of the tank at the same time. So it's not exactly have to be perfect. The first time I did a set of these, man, I was taking a piece of string and measuring from the center of this over to here, making a mark on tape from the bolt up here back over here, making a mark on the tape. So I had this edge and I had this edge, and it's just not necessary to do. If you can get it pretty close, that's, you're going to be fine. Inside a little bag, you'll have the 3M sticky tape. So we're going to go ahead and go over to the table and place these on the back of the badges first, and then we'll put them on the tank. What I did is basically laid down the corner and just folded it on. These move, so make sure that you're not putting, you know, pulling on it and, you know, stretching this out. So make sure you got everything lined up before you press it on. And I apologize, I should have moved the camera over there for that, but I didn't. Once I get that on there, we're gonna peel the other side. And what I'm gonna do, is I'm gonna tack that top and just kind of let it hang a little bit and stand back and look at it. Okay, it's a little bit low for me. A little bit more forward. Tack the top again. Stand back and look at it. Yeah, I like it right there. So once I get it exactly where I want it, it's gonna hold for about 15 seconds. And that's pretty much it. That's how you stick it. So I'm gonna go to the other side, I'm gonna stick it, and then we'll kind of walk around it with the camera and see what it looks like. So hopefully that walk around showed you what they look like on both sides of the tank. Like I said, you can't see both sides of the tank at the same time, so you're in luck. You don't have to be exactly perfect with it, but you want to get it pretty close. So that's how we do our tank badges here at Sick Baggers. I hope this video helped you. So if you want to get your hands on a set of these, like I said, I'll put the link down in the description down below over to Jay Choppers, to the website, and also to his Facebook. And make sure to check out the rest of his website too, because he's got a whole slew of parts on his website, not just these little tank badges. And those are the tank badges that we strictly use here at Sick Baggers. We absolutely love them. We've got them on the Street Glide, on the Road Glide, and now the 2024 Road Glide. If you have any questions on this one though, you know the deal, comment section down below. I'll help you the best that I can. Make sure to check out the rest of the YouTube channel. We got over 130 bagger and softail related videos, most of those being install videos or service and maintenance videos. If this video helps you, hit that like and hit that subscribe. That's what keeps us coming out here and making these videos for you. I'm gonna get out of here and get myself back to work. I hope to see you in the next video, but until then, as always, be safe, keep your knees in the breeze. Hey, thanks for stopping by and checking out our videos today. If you like what you see, make sure you hit that like button, hit the little subscribe button popping up over here. If you want to check out more of our content, I've got two videos right here that'll get you started. Not really gonna say anything else, just click one of those videos and take you to another video.